Good morning to all.
Good morning, sir.
Last class, I have shown you a video in which Walter Levin was standing on a Van de Graaff generator and touching it. The whole of his body was charged. Right? Do you people remember this?
Yes, sir.
I'm showing you a video of the working principle of Van de Graaff generator. Please see this. Though on this JE never asked any direct questions, but indirect questions have been asked, the working principle should be known to you. Have a look. This explanation is very well given.
It is designed by American physicist Robert J. Van de Graaff. It is based on the principle that if a charged conductor is brought internally in contact with the hollow conductor, all the charges from the inner conductor is transferred to the surface of outer conductor. No matter what amount of charge is already present on outer shell. A simple Van de Graaff generator consists of a belt made of rubber running over a pair of rollers, one of which is surrounded by a hollow metallic sphere mounted on an insulated stand. Electrons' emitter in the form of comb made up of sharp metal points is positioned near the lower roller in such a way that the comb is pointed towards the rubber belt. The comb is maintained at high positive voltage by external supply. Another comb, called receiver comb, is positional near the upper roller and is connected to a hollow metal sphere. A motor is connected to a bottom roller in order to move the belt. When the motor is turned on, the belt moves over the pulley. Spray comb positioned near the lower roller, which is connected to high positive potential, sprays positive charges on the outer side of the belt. Charges on the belt are carried upwards and are collected by the receiver comb on the top of the generator. Since the upper comb is connected to hollow conductor, the charge gets transferred to a hollow sphere. Since the belt continuously carries positive charge to the receiver comb, the spherical shell collects enormous amount of charges and develops huge potential. It becomes difficult for the surface to hold more and more charges due to the force of repulsion between the light charges on the dome. When the potential of the spherical shell exceeds the breakdown value of air, air around the sphere gets ionized and leakage of charge takes place from the sphere. Van de Graaff generator produces a beam of high energy particles in the range greater than megavolt.
Did you people understand how the Van de Graaff generator works?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Write in your class notes, you will have to draw this diagram. Van de Graaff generator, this is the outer sphere, inner cylinder connected to another inner cylinder. This is made to rotate. Here you have a brush. The charge leaves from here, first comes here, and then accumulated on the outer sphere. This is made to rotate. Brush with the belt using friction will generate charge which will move up. This connected, and you are aware of the fact from the shielding concept that the charge will always go to the outer sphere when connected. Now, this was the outer sphere which Walter Levin touched, and he had charge all over his body. but he played it smart. He stood on a proper insulating stand and he touches. Without an insulating stand, you touch that, that is at high potential, it will start electrocuting the person. Draw this diagram. The diagram is very much self-explanatory, but you should know the working principle of Van de Graaff gentle. Thank you.